My name's Rory Wilson. I'm a professor of zoology in Swansea University in Wales in the UK. My subject area is the study of animal movement, and so why animals move, where they move to. I became interested in animal movement. It was a gradual process. I suppose you get to realise that everything moves, the universe moves, it's expanding, the geological things move, plate tectonics, the earth moves. And the cool thing about animals, which I sort of identified at about the age of about 15, was that they move in terribly unpredictable ways, and lots of things don't do that. When people first got into animals moving and the interest in animals moving, they just described them. We've got from just looking at how animals move to actually being putting tags on them to see exactly where they move, even when we can't see them. So we can follow whales when they're a kilometre underwater, or we can follow soaring birds a kilometre up in the air. Some of the landmark or cutting edge work has actually been in realising the technology to allow us to look at animals. It's enabled us to look at things like the dynamics of the hunting cheetah. It's enabled us to look at problems like why the wandering albatross population has been plummeting over the last 10, 20, 30 years. Animal movement's in everything we do. It's in how we put livestock out in the fields. It affects the way we move. And so everything you can possibly think about relates to animal movement. And then, of course, there's the human aspect. We tend to think of ourselves as exempt from animal movement because we're not animals. But hey, the news is we are. And that if you look at the way humans move within cities, for example, then you can say, well, we could make everybody's life easier if we did this or we did that. The study of animal movement goes from the importance of how bacteria move up to blue whales and everything in between. And the next big thing is called predicting animal movement. Because what we've done in the past is everyone says, ooh, a cheetah can run at 70 miles an hour. Or, did you know that a Bartel Godwit can fly for 5 days without stopping? And that's just description. How cool would it be if you could look at an animal and say, I'm going to tell you what it's going to do next, and you'd be right. So it's a very big field, so you can study all sorts of things. You can study animal migration at a big scale. You can look at animal control, like locusts, and how you find out where they go and what they're going to do. You can study animal movement in a population sense, how a population's expanding and changing due to climate change and so on and so forth. Because animal movement science requires so much from so many different disciplines, you need a country that's small, condensed, teeming with ideas, and where people are going to work together. And you get a lot of that in the UK, and what we do is we stretch out and work with people in different areas of the world. And actually, interestingly, we get lots of students who for undergraduate projects come in and say, can we have some of your animal tag data? We think we can turn it into something that will be really interesting for you. And they can mix it all together, and they can create incredible visualizations. And suddenly you realize that the computer scientist has made us see the way animals are behaving and the way they're moving in a particular way that we would probably never have come across before if we tried to do it ourselves. When you put a tag on a new animal that's never been tagged before, you have no idea what's going to come out of the book when the tag comes back. So you take it off, you read it out, you put it on the computer, and all of a sudden there's this incredible story that's been written by the animal about where it's been and what it's done. And you know, you're the first person to open the book on it. It's really a thrill.